In this video, I'm going to show you how to install the firmware 2.0 on the FX3 using a Mac, because there are some steps that people get hung up on. So I want to ensure that you have a smooth install. Firmware 2.0 brings some really cool features to the FX3, but we'll get into that later in the video. Right now, let's go through the steps that you need to do before you start installing the software on a Mac, especially an M1 Mac. But the Apple Silicon or Intel Macs have a similar workflow. You just have to download a different driver for each. One of the first things that you need to know is that the battery has to be fully charged. If it's not, it won't let you do the install. So that's number one. Number two is you have to make sure that the firmware is 1.01 or lower or earlier. And the way that you check that is you go into, you press menu, you go all the way to the bottom, go to the suitcase, go all the way to the bottom, and go to number 12 where it says setup options. And then all the way at the bottom, it has your version. You should be able to see what version of the firmware you have installed at right now. Next, you need to change something on the camera that is very specific to this setup process. So being in the menu, also in the suitcase, go to number 10 where it says USB, click on that. And then where it says USB connection mode, click it and make sure that you set it to mass storage. This will connect the FX3 properly to the computer for the update. Make sure that you take out all your SD cards and that it is out. Get yourself a USB-C cable that connects to the computer. So now on the download and install section of the Sony website, there's a link in the description for the firmware you can download, but you also have to download the driver for your Mac. And on that download page, if you scroll down to the bottom, there are two downloads, one for Apple Silicon and one for the Intel processor. Download the one that is right for your computer. So if an M1, M1 Pro, M1 Max, or M1 Ultra chip in your computer, if you have one of those computers, make sure you get the silicon. If you have an Intel machine, make sure you download that one. And the best way to check that is go up to the menu, click on the Apple icon and click on the About Mac, and you'll find the info about your computer there. So go to your downloads and find the Sony camera driver.package. Double click it to open it up and go through the process. Put in your password. You'll be prompted to allow the application to install new software. Type in your password. Now, this is the part that some people do get kind of hung up, because in some cases, it may ask you that your system extensions are blocked, that you're trying to load a program that you downloaded from the internet. Do not press OK here. Make sure you press Open Security Preferences. This will take you to another dialog box where you have to type in your password again, and then it will take you to the Security and Privacy tab. Click on General, and down at the bottom, there's a little lock. Make sure you click on that to unlock that page. And then right above that, it should say that system software from developer Sony Image Products and Solutions Inc. was blocked from loading. Click the Allow button. This will allow the program to install itself on your computer. If you don't click on that, you won't be able to install it and the driver won't install properly. You'll have to go through this entire process again and you may need to go searching for where that is. So once that is done, you may need to restart the computer. So go ahead and restart the computer at that point. And then you go through the installation process for the actual firmware. Make sure that your camera is off, plug the USB into the camera and then plug it into the computer. And then turn your camera on. It will show you mass storage USB is connecting. Then find the system software updater in your downloads. Double click it. There should be a little application called system software updater. Click on that, put in your password. And as you go through these steps, just make sure you read everything that's on screen because it will guide you through and how long this will take and what to do with your computer or what not to do. Once everything's set and it recognizes the camera, click next. If the battery isn't fully charged or there's some other issue, it will tell you that there is an error and it won't actually start the process. So during this entire process, make sure you don't turn off the camera, don't touch the computer, don't let your computer go to sleep. This will take about 30 minutes. Do not disconnect anything. You want to make sure that your camera and your computer are nice and fine. Then once the whole thing is done, you press finished. You should be good to go. Just wait for it to be done. One of the really cool things is that during this update, it takes you to the auto heating shutoff. It actually sets up the overheating of the FX3 to make sure that it prioritizes recording over camera heat. So this allows you to do longer recordings. And the cool features that are in this firmware update are in this video, which my good friend Josh has made a whole run through about the entire firmware update, all the cool things that are in it. So make sure you go check it out and give him a subscribe. I'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.